Hello, welcome to this channel. My name is Alice Rita. If you are a first timer on this channel, my name is Alice Rita and I record tutorials on ImageJ tutorial on LD recipe. I share some writing tips that helped me during my thesis writing. So I'm sharing some tutorials on what Microsoft Word and on EndNotes referencing. If you would like me to assist you with something, please write in the comment section. In my video today, I'm going to be describing to you how to make a profile plot for image for confocal images that has more than three fluorescence channels. Someone recently asked me in one of my videos. So here I have this video from last year that I showed how to make a profile plot for multiple channel. However, in that video, I describe how to do it for image that has three fluorescence channel, and if you use this approach, you cannot use it for a fluorescence channel that has for a microscope image that has more than four fluorescence signal. So how do you do this? Because I've never acquired any images with such number of fluorescence protein, I've searched here in Google and I found this confocal microscopy fluorescent protein color. So they have different palette. And I've downloaded this and I'm going to be using the image from this website, which is from Olympus Microscope. I'm going to be using it for the purpose of our tutorial so as to show you step by step. So here is the image, and what I have done is to crop out the different, using the rectangle tool, I've cropped out each section of these images so that I can then overlap them together later. So that's what I've done, and I've just moved this square across each box so that I can have image that has similar size. And in order to be able to not mix them up, I've labeled them by their names by putting the name of the sample according to the name that the company has assigned to them. So I'm going to be closing this. And here is what the beautiful image looked like after I merged the five of the fluorescence together. I'm also going to close that and we are going to be working. I'm going to close this. Do not save. So I'm going to put this by going to Window, click on Tile, and that way I'm able to arrange the five fluorescence different protein together. And if you want to merge these together, all you just have to do is to go to Image, Color, Merge Channel. And that way you can choose the different color that you want to merge. That's the five channel. So the M cyan is more of a, let's see, there's no gray. It's a cyan. We have a green and there is a yellow. Anyway, you then just click OK. And this gives you this beautiful merged image. The reason why I said that you cannot use the method I've used to describe for the earlier video I recorded last year is because in that method, I used a RGB profile plot, which means R is for red, G is for green, and blue, B is for blue, meaning image that has three fluorescence. So if you do that, that means you'll be going to plugin and this is currently in 8-bit, so we're going to need to convert this to 8-bit. So I'll just go to type, click RGB color, and now we have this image in RGB. And then I can go to RGB profiler, first draw a line, and go to plugin, RGB profiler, and then you can see that despite the fact that we've merged a green, a cyan, a yellow, a red together, we could only get three plots for that image. So that is why this is not going to work. So how do I then show that a profile plot for an image that has five color? I'm going to be applying a method which measures each fluorescence individually and then combine them together. And please come along with me. Let me show you how to do this. I'm going to draw a line across the image in order to ensure that the line I'm drawing across this image, that it's representative across all the image. After I finish drawing the first one, I'm going to go to Analyze Tools and look for the Roy Manager, and that automatically open this one that is here. I will just quickly delete this so that we have a also close it so that you get the angle of what I'm saying. So I have here selected my line tool. I'm going to be drawing it across this image. Let me ensure that I draw a very long one. Okay. And I'm going to go to Analyze Tools, Roy Manager. That open up this page, and I'm going to click on Hard. You can automatically press the letter T key on your keyboard, and that adds us to the Roy Manager without having to go through the long process. Next, I'm going to click on the next one. Then I come back to the Roy Manager, and that places the line on the next fluorescence image. And I'm just going to repeat this 5 times. That way, I ensure that the line I've drawn across the sample is the same size, so that when I'm going to do my analysis, it's going to be representative. Next, I'm going to go to Analyze and go for a profile plot. When I click on a profile plot, you can see that that's made a single plot for this particular image titled Yellow. And you can see here, we have our plot of yellow. The next thing I'm going to do is to modify this plot that is yellow immediately by going to Content Style, which I'm going to click on. And because our plot is yellow, I'm going to be changing it from black immediately to a yellow. And I'm going to increase the line width to, let's say, 4, just to make it bigger. And click OK. Can you see that makes this line to be visible and it's no longer black but yellow? Next, I'm going to repeat that process for the green sample. And do not rush to sign off this video, because the last part of this tutorial is very vital for the purpose of what you need it for. So I'm going to then click on the next image, and I will try as much as possible to go faster now so that I don't keep you waiting to the end. So I'm just now going to change this plot of green to a green, and also change the line width to be 4. You can see that brightens the width of the plot. So you can see we have the 2. I'm going to repeat that for the M cherry by just pressing Command R for rabbits. I'm not good at pronouncing that very well, so R for rabbit, Control R. And then I'm just going to then quickly change that to red. M cherry should be a red color, a width of 4. You see that also brightens up. I'm going to repeat Control R for the cerulean, which is the cyan. Content Style, change it to cyan, and also 4. And then the last one, which is plum, because plum also is red, I'm going to be using a magenta for that color. Magenta, also a line width of 4. Oh, I spelled my magenta wrongly, that was why. Okay, so now you see we have this. In order to visualize this all at once, I'm going to go to Window and Tile. Oh, I need to unfrozen my plot first to be able to put them as tile. I don't want to freeze my plot yet, so what I will do is to show you one after the other. Can you see all the different shades of plots that we have? Because these plots, even though they look like they are similar, you can see that their peak is not completely similar. So you can see this. Okay, the next most important step that is important for you to put all this together and have a reasonable plot is to then go to Data. You can pick any of the plots to do the combination of these plots together. You go to Data, click on Hard from Plot, and when I click Hard from Plot, it automatically opens one of the plots. You can see we are working with plot with the plum. It shows yellow. If I choose green, it will replace that. So first, I'm going to be adding the yellow, And I will say, okay, that's beautiful. I love the combination. I'm going to repeat that step and click add from plot. I'm going to be choosing the next color now. I'm going to be choosing a green. Also, now I'm having the magenta, the green, the yellow. How about the other colors that we have? I'm going to go to from below the data. If I have frozen this plot, I will not be able to do my hardening, and that's why I did not freeze it first, but rather go to data from the plot, hard from plot. And now I'm going to be hardening a cherry, which I put in red, remember? Can you see now we're having four colors? And the next thing I'm going to be doing, actually, I changed my mind. I'm going to change the cherry to an orange color just to be able to ensure that people with color blind can still be able to get the grasp of the color that we have. So I'm going to change that to orange rather than a red. Okay, so that's okay. I will come back here and hard from plot. Change the. Can you see automatically the red has been changed to the orange color? I still hope the colorblind people can see this color. Anyway, I'm going to then add the cyan color. And as you can see, now we have this beautiful plot from our images. So the next thing I will do now is to then do the final editing of this plot to make it more beautiful, which is just to go to axis option. I'm going to be increasing the font size from 14 to like 20 just to make it beautiful. I'm going to be bolding the title of the axis. And instead of the gray value, I can just write intensity, change that to intensity. And we can then click OK. If you don't want these background boxes to show, you can go back to more and click on axis option again. Yes, axis option. And you can untick the grid. So as you can see, immediately I untick that, the box is disappearing. You can untick all of them. No, I want my numbers to be showing. And now, click OK. Can you see that now you have a plot that is very beautiful, no background noise, and it's five fluorescence image. So to finish this off, go to More, click on Freeze Plots. That way, this plot is now frozen. It cannot move about if you move your mouse. Before, if I move my mouse around, it will move a bit. And the next thing I'll go to is to go to more high resolution plots. And I said, okay, that's beautiful. And now this plot has been projected into a picture. I can no longer edit this. If you want to do more beautification, maybe to choose an RGB color palette from your what do I call it now? From your Excel sheet, what you can then do is to go to data, click on save data. That way you'll be able to export the value. I'll click intensity, export the value of those plots and click, let me save this on a desktop. Or let me save that in download. Click save. If I go to the download folder, I should have the values for each of those plots in a single Excel document. So you can see it here. I'm going to right click, open with Excel. One minute, please. Just opening my Excel file. Taking a while for the document to open. Okay, come on now, Excel. Okay. So you can see that it has plotted the. We have here is the distance of the of our x-axis, which is this. This is our x-axis, the distance in pixel. and each of these plots in the Excel file, the intensity, Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, each of them correspond to the fluorescence that we added together. So it's accordingly, the Y1 corresponds to the first one you added, the second, and the last one I added was the cyan, so that should be the Y4. And in order to mix them together, you can actually then export each of these plots individually. And because we finished working with the other plots, I'm just going to close them so that I can then show you what we have done today. So with this, I'm going to put it as a tile. Can you see that here is the original data that I've frozen? I can still modify if I want to do any modification. I'm going to close this because we've exported it. This is our high resolution plot, which I'm going to minimize, and you can see. You can then arrange these four together, these five together, and put the plots beside it. If you found my tutorial useful, please support me by subscribing to my channel, and I hope to get your feedback in the comment section if you found this useful or if you have a better way you would have done it. Remember, ImageJ is a free software, and please remember to always reference the software in your publication. And until next time, bye.